Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at swipe typing on the iPhone and iPad using iOS 13. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So swipe typing isn't new because you could for a while now add third-party keyboards, and many of those third-party keyboards supported swipe typing. However, what's new is now it's built in to iOS, so you can do it with the native keyboard and it works really well. Swipe typing can significantly speed up your typing, especially on the iPhone where most of us are just tapping with one finger. Let's take a look at me doing it on the iPhone, and I'm not doing it here at full speed. I'm doing it a little bit slower and more deliberately to show you how it works. So Apple's name for swipe typing is QuickPath, and the way to use it is just use the regular keyboard. So you could be tapping out letters just like you normally do and then switch without having to turn on any control or anything. Just switch to QuickPath. Just tap on the first letter and without lifting up your finger, move your finger to the next letter and then the next letter and the next letter until you complete the word, then lift your finger up. And then the word should appear and it knows this is a complete word. So the next time you tap on a letter and start swiping around, it knows it's doing another word. So the space is automatic. And you could switch between tapping individual letters and swiping as much as you want. So a few things you should know about swipe typing. First is you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to get your finger over the exact letters. Matter of fact, you can sometimes even skip letters because it's going to kind of figure out what's the most likely thing that you're trying to swipe type and it's going to put it there. Second thing is it doesn't always get it right. A lot of words are very close to each other on the keyboard and it's going to sometimes pick the wrong one. But if you look closely at the top of the keyboard, you'll see the predictions there. And most of the time when it gets it wrong, the right one is one of those words. So you just quickly tap that, correct the word, and then move on. There are a couple settings we should look at. If you go into Settings and then in General, Keyboard, at the bottom you'll see the settings for QuickPath. Now strangely Apple doesn't call it QuickPath here, they call it Slide to Type. So you've got the on off switch for that. And if you have it on, there's another option for Delete Slide to Type by Word. So what happens there is if you type a word, you hit the Delete key immediately afterwards, the entire word gets deleted. This can speed things up, as if you get a word really wrong, hit delete once and then you try again. Let's take a look at me doing this on the iPad. The iPad is a little different because the default keyboard, the one that fills the whole bottom half of the screen, that one doesn't do swipe typing. But the new floating keyboard in iOS 13 does, so you have to switch to that. So to switch to the floating keyboard, you want to tap and hold the keyboard button at the bottom right and then switch to floating. And now you get a keyboard that's basically the same size as the iPhone keyboard and you can use QuickPath on it. So you can type here. And it works the same way. It feels just like typing on the iPhone. I guess the idea is that you're going to be doing QuickPath with one finger anyway, so don't have the keys spread out all over the keyboard so you're moving your arm around to do it. But you can of course move the floating keyboard around so you can position it on the screen where it's not in the way of other things and it's most comfortable for you to type. Now swipe typing isn't magic. You still need to work at typing. It's just going to speed things up a little bit. It's not going to get things perfect, but neither is pecking at each individual key. Once you get used to it, it definitely does improve your speed. It could take a few seconds off of responding to a text message. It can make typing a response in an email much quicker. And if you do a lot of writing on your iPhone or iPad, you could definitely see a speed improvement as you get better at it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.